Welcome to Technia TV. Good morning everyone. I, Jyotsna, faculty of MBA department. Today, I'm going to deliver a lecture on the topic Sales of Goods Act. Sales of communities constitute the one of the most important type of contract under the law in India. India is also one of the most largest economies and have a great relevance where and thus an adequate checks and measures to ensure the safety and prosperity of its business and commerce community. Till 1930, transactions related to sale and purchase of goods were regulated by the Indian Contract Act 1872. In 1930, Section 76 to 123 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 were repealed and separated act called the Indian Sales of Goods Act 1930 was passed. With effect from 22nd September 1963, the word Indian was being removed. Now the present act is called the Sales of Goods Act 1930. This act extends to whole of India except the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The scope of the act: the Sales of Goods Act deals with Sales of Goods Act 1930. Contract of sale of good is a contract whereby the seller transfer or agree to transfer the property and goods to the buyer for a price. Contract of sale is a generic term which includes both a sale as well as an agreement to sell. Now, the next main important topic is what are the essential elements of a contract of sale. Number one, the seller and a buyer. There should be a seller as well as the buyer. Buyer means a person who buys or agree to buy the goods. Section 29.10. Seller means a person who sells or agree to sell goods. Section 29.13. Number two, goods. There may be some goods. Goods means every kind of movable property other than actionable claims, and money includes stock and shares, growing crops, grass and things attached to or forming parts of the land which are agreed to us several before sale or under the contract of sale. Section 2, subsection 7. Number 3, transfer of property. Property means general property in goods and not the merely a special property. Section 2, subsection 11. General property in goods means ownership of the goods. Special property in goods means possession of the goods. Thus, there must be either a transfer of ownership of goods or an agreement to transfer the ownership of goods. The ownership may transfer either immediately on completion of sale or sometime in futures in agreement to sale. Number 4, the price. There must be a price. Price here means the money consideration for a sales of good. Section 2, subsection 10. When the consideration is only goods, its amounts to a barter and not a sale. When there is no consideration, its amounts to gift and not sale. Number 5, the main point is essential elements of a valid contract. In addition to the aforesaid special essential elements, all the essential elements of a valid contract as specified under Section 10 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 must also be present, since a contract of sale is a special type of contract. So I hope you understand the lecture, what is Sales of Goods Act and what are the essential elements of a valid sale. So I hope you understand this lecture. For more videos, please subscribe this video and likes. Thank you.